student, welcome to AD Lab. In this lab, I will explain design and fourth experiment, that is design and implement half adder, full adder, half subtractor, full subtractor using basic gates. So the required components are, we want here one NOT gate IC7404, then two input AND gate IC7408, then two input OR gate, then we need a three input AND gate 7411, then digital trainer kit patch cords. So after that we need to implement this one by using Xilinx software. That is a separate part. Now let us see the IC. These are the IC required: 7404, 7408, 7432. This is the half adder circuit diagram. Actually, half adder is a digital block in the digital circuit. So, half adder adds two bits. So, in this diagram, you can see it will add two bit A and B, and it will provide sum and carry. So, to implement the half adder, we use here trainer kit. In the trainer kit, first I will connect. So here you can see we have connected three ICs. In my last video I explained how to insert the IC into trainer kit. This is 7404 and this is 7408 and this is 7432. So three ICs are required to implement half adder circuit. First we need to do the VCC and ground connection. So since it is a 14 pin IC, 14 is the VCC. So here it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So 14 is the VCC. Let me connect the VCC first. 14 is the VCC. Then 7 is the ground. So 7 is the ground. Similarly, I will connect VCC and ground for the other ICs. This is 7408 IC. And ground connection for 7408 IC. And once again 7432 OR gate, 2 input OR gate IC. Sorry, ground connection for 7432. Initially I will take 2 input A and B. You can see here this is A, input A, and one more cord I will take as input B. So input A goes to pin number 1 of inverter 7404. So this is the pin number 1. From pin number 2, here you can see pin number 2 goes to pin number 1 of the AND gate. So pin number 2 output goes to pin number 1 of the AND gate. Similarly here you can see one connection from A directly goes to pin number 4. So I will take one connection from A. I will take from this point only. This point only goes to pin number 4 of the AND gate. So pin number 4 of the AND gate is 1, 2, 3, 4. Pin number 4 of the AND gate. Then from there same connection goes to pin number 9. So same connection goes to pin number 9. So I will take a tapping like this. From pin number 4. The next connection goes to pin number 9. So pin number 9 of the AND gate. So 5, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Pin number 9 of the AND gate. So this connection is over now. Now from the pin number 2, one connection goes to the pin number 1. Only one connection. Like this, you have to do the other connection from the second input. The second input goes to pin number 3 of the inverter. Pin number 3 of the 7404. Pin number 3 of 7404. From there, one more tapping goes to pin number 2. I will take one tapping, goes to pin number 2 of the AND gate. 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 Similarly, one more connection from same point goes to pin number 10. So one more connection from the same point. So let me connect from here. Same point goes to pin number 10 of the AND gate. So now I have completed these connections. Pin number 3 is connected to pin number 2 and pin number 2 is connected to pin number 10. Now I'll take the output of this inverter, that is pin number 4. Pin number 4 goes to 5, only one connection. So pin number 4, here output of this output point goes to 5 of the AND gate. 5 of the AND gate here. 5 of the AND gate. So we have completed with wall connection. Now output of the AND gate 3 goes to This is the output of the AND gate 3 goes to OR gate, pin number 1 of the OR gate. So I will connect this one now. Next IC, pin 1 of the OR gate. Similarly, output of the AND gate 6 goes to pin number 2. Output of the AND gate, see, this is the AND gate 6 goes to pin number 2 of a OR gate. Now output of this OR gate is sum. So output of this OR gate is connected to sum. Similarly, we have one more AND gate here. One more AND gate, pin number 8, and that is nothing but directly it is a carry. So pin number 8 is connected to output of the OR gate, that is carry. So now this is the implementation of the adder circuit. Now this is input A and B, and this is the output, that is nothing but sum and carry. Now we'll see this how it works. So this is the truth table for half adder. I said half adder is the important component of a digital circuit. So it will add 2 bits like A and B. So when you add 2 bits, 0, 0, sum is 0, carry 0. When you add 0, 1, sum is 1, carry is 0. When you add 1, 0, sum is 1 and carry is 0. And when you add 1 and 1, sum is 0 actually and carry is 1. The disadvantage of the half adder is it cannot add carry from the previous stage. In order to avoid that one, we will use a full adder. But the implementation circuit for the half adder, this is the implementation circuit. So you can directly see here, by seeing the truth table, you can write this expression, or you can simplify this expression by using a KMF. For that, you please. So let me switch on the trainer kit. This is the implementation of this one half adder circuit diagram, as I explained earlier. So now you can see we have two input A and B. A is 0, B is 0, sum is 0, carry is 0. When you make input 0 and 1, sum is 1, carry is 0. When you make input is 1 and 0, that is A is 1 and B is 0, sum is 1, carry is 0. And when you make both inputs high, then sum is 0. 1 plus 1 actually 0 here, 0, and carry is equal to 1. So in full adder, we are going to add 3 bits, that is A and B, and carry from the previous stage. So when you are using 3 bits, you will get 8 combinations, sum and carry. So here, when you add 0, 0, 0 plus 0 is 0, 0 plus 0 is 0, so sum is 0, carry is 0. So second combination, 0 plus 0 is 0, 0 plus 1 is 1, sum is 1, carry is 0. Third combination, 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 0 is 1, sum is 1, carry is 0. Fourth combination is 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 1 is 0, carries 1. Fifth combination is 1 plus 0, 1. And once again, 1 plus 0, 1, carries 0. Seventh combination is 1 plus 0, 1. 1 plus 1 is 0, carries 1. Eighth combination is 1 plus 1 is 0 and carries 1. And ninth combination is 1 plus 1 is 1. 1 plus 1 is 1. So it is 1 plus 1. Sum is 1 and carry is 1. While solving this one by using K-map, you will get the expression for sum and expression for carry. And the circuit diagram for this one is. So this is the circuit diagram for full adder circuit. This is the circuit diagram for full adder circuits. Here you can see we have drawn the circuit diagram for full adder by using NOT gate, NAND gate, and AND gate, and OR gate. Here we are using like NOT gate and two AND gate of three input. So you can see here, this one, this two AND gate consist in one IC, and this two AND gate consist in one IC. And other than that, we have once again two input, two AND gates we are using for this section. And finally, for sum and carry also, we are using OR gates and 432. So totally, we need here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 ICs. You can see here. First one is a 7404. 7404 is a NOT gate. Second one is 7411. 7411 is a 3 input AND gate. So third one is 7411, 3 input AND gate. Fourth one is 7432, 2 input OR gate. 7432, 2 input OR gate. And 7408. So 08 is a 2 input AND gate. So ICs, all ICs are connected like this. For example, you know anyway how to connect these ICs and all. This ICs will connect like this. And since it is a 14 pin IC here, pin number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 7, 7, and this is 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So it is a 14 pin IC. Let me repeat once again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And this one is pin number 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. And you can see here VCC and ground connection. You can use this also for VCC and ground. Similarly, this also. Here, this is a 28 pin IC holder. But we are using 14 pin IC. So here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7. And this is 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So now we will see implementation of this one. First you have to connect VCC and ground. So we know 14 is VCC and 7 is ground. So for all the IC, 14 is VCC, 7 is ground. 14 is VCC, 7 is ground. Here also, this one, this is 14, pin number 14 this is. This one you have to connect it to VCC and 7 you have to connect it to ground. You can use either this or this ground, or this ground or this ground, or this VCC or this VCC. Students, this is the implementation of full adder. It makes use of 6 ICs. You can implement the same circuit by using XOR gates also, but exclusive OR gate. But in syllabus it is mentioned that you have to implement this one by using basic gates only. That's why we have used basic gates here. So now let me switch on the trainer kit. Now these are the input A, B and carry in. A, B and carry in from the previous stage. This is the output sum and carry. So you can see here the truth table 0, 0, 0. First combination 0, 0, 0. So let me give you 0, 0, 0. Output is sum is 0, carry is 0. 0, 0, 1. Second combination 0, 0, 1. You can see 0, 0, 1. Sum is 1, carry is 0. Similarly, 0, 1, 0. Sum is 1, carry is 0. 0, 1, 1. Sum is 0. You can see here, carry is 1.
then 100 sum is 1 carry 0, 101 sum is 0 carries 1, then 110 sum is 0 carries 1, 111 last combination, you can see in the truth table also last combination here, 111 is sum is 1 carries 1, sum is 1 carries 1. So in this way you can implement a full subtractor also. So this is the implementation of a half adder and a full adder. Thank you.